okay, now that this thing is about to get rolling again, I'm out here and I just want to give some shout outs and some praises to the United States Postal Service workers. Now, I know, you know what? Now, I know this video was a long time coming. They say, Josh, but what about the mail deliverers and the mail carriers and the people that go to the houses and pushing their lives every day and putting their life on the line? I got you. Calm down. Wait. Don't even move yet. I was doing this thing to prepare for you. Wait, some wind coming. Okay, now the wind has passed. I want to thank every single United States postal worker, from the people that package, to the people that deliver, to the people that work at the counter, to the people that disinfect every single thing we touch. We know and we appreciate you on a level that we will never be able to comprehend, or you'll be able to comprehend, or a level that we can never dignify, justify, ratify, magnify all the fires in the world. We could never show our appreciation for you and what you have done. Wait, wind is coming. It is because of you that I was able to send and receive things. It's because of you that that stimulus check that wouldn't hit that bank account because my routing numbers was messed up. Y'all was able to send me a full paper check and I was able to go deposit that, cash that, and lose all that in the stock market. Don't worry, get out of my business. Wait, wind is coming. It is because of you that I was able to check on my family through mail because technology wasn't always a thing to use. It's because of you that I was able to send and receive packages that I needed, medical supplies and food and other things that I wouldn't be able to get without you. So for every postal worker and delivery driver, UPS, FedEx, DHL, if DHL is still open, for all y'all that felt ignored and unappreciated, you are an essential worker. You are an essential human being. Your commitment to your profession, your commitment to your job, your commitment to understanding, and your commitment to everything. You are an example of what this country should be, could be, and will be when this thing opens back up. When a young man grows up as a child, usually we want to be a firefighter or a football player, baseball player, basketball player. Because of the way this pandemic was handled and because of the commitment you showed, I wouldn't be shocked at all if my sons comes up to me and tell me that they want to work for the United States Postal Service. Now, I'm going to tell my children it's a lot of walking, it's a lot of talking, it's a lot of touching stuff. You got to drive on the other side of the car in the United States. You got to open mail. I couldn't do it because I'm a little bit too lazy to do it. I'm sorry. I apologize. But for y'all, y'all are the new wave. Wind is coming. Have a good day. Probably got some alone time with you. Your boy, he ain't paying attention to the hints you putting down. But I see you with your little bucket hat and stuff. Yeah, so what's up, man? How old you is? 21, 22, 23? Breathe when I got it right. 24, 25. Don't hold your breath. Okay, nah. Listen. I'm just trying to make this thing possible, like Kim was the first name and stuff like that, you know?
I think Coach Storr needs you on
the field. He don't need me, we need this. Listen, you can stay here and listen to this forever, because it's going to be forever, or you can walk away and just miss the opportunity.
My boyfriend, my coach is calling me. Yes,
you gonna,
Coach Storr?
You going to walk away?